Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. In last session, I shared the diagram of this mobile charger, and today we will see its checkpoints because it is using 5VA70DA14A IC. This IC don't have any circuit diagram, any troubleshooting manual, any sample circuit. So let's check it. If you don't have good practical experience in electronics, never try to repair because it is using live voltage. It is just idea to troubleshoot this type of IC. I am connecting power using series lamp. While testing, we need very special care because it have very little space for working. I will connect a USB tester in the output so that the voltage value will be visible on the screen here. Now I will turn it on. It is showing 5.25 volts. AC voltage. At input 235 volts. Then we have DC voltage. We can test in the output of the bridge rectifier. It is 334 volts. At this capacitor 334 volt DC. Now if we check voltage at pin number 1, that is startup pin, it is without load. I will connect one lead to the capacitor negative terminal as a primary ground. Connect to pin number 1, it is 19 volt, no load. No load. If I will connect load, now we will check voltage at pin number 1. Ground. It is 21 volt and it is changing with the change in current. We can say it is 21 volt. It is varying as per load. How much current will draw here in the mobile? The amount of current will cause to drop the voltage. When the voltage will drop at pin number 3, it will change its duty cycle to increase the voltage in the primary. So 21 volt VCC pin is changing at 21 volt with 1.5 ampere load. Now we will monitor pin number 3. Ground and pin number 3. It is 0.63 volt. This 0.63 volts are from this voltage divider network. 0.62, 0.66. These voltage are based on this current rating. If I will remove the charger, voltage at pin number 3 are 0.199. These are now stable, 0.2. But when we connect the load, pin number 3 is now increasing. Why? Because when we put load, the voltage value change at pin number 3. Because when we put load, this voltage will drop. To compensate this voltage drop, this IC will increase its duty cycle. In my last video, I told that with the load, the voltage will increase. No, when we put load, the voltage drop here to compensate this voltage drop, it will increase its duty cycle to increase the current in this primary. So that voltage will increase here, because here is load. The voltage will remain 5.2 volt, but in result, because here is no load, here is the regular load. So here will become a voltage rise. When this voltage will increase, this IC will determine the load size. So pin number 3 is now 0.6 volt, 0.5 volt at approximately 1 ampere load. When the load will increase, this voltage will increase as well. Let me increase the load. Now the load is increased at 1.8 ampere. If we check pin number 1, now 21.65 volt. And if we check now pin number 3, it is now 0.76 volt. So this pin will monitor the amount of voltage. How much voltage and what is the load size in the output. In the same time, at pin number 4, there is current sense resistor. At no load, it is just only 0.001 volt. We can say 1 millivolt. But when we will increase load, when I added the load, it is 44 millivolt. So this IC will come to know that when there is 0.44 millivolt across this resistor, what is the output current? So it will monitor the amount of current based on these dropped voltage. Let's check on oscilloscope. I will connect a wire here to connect ground at negative terminal of the capacitor. When you are using oscilloscope, always try to use isolation transformer or use battery powered oscilloscope. When we are testing live voltage, never touch this metallic connector. If you don't have isolation transformer, use battery powered oscilloscope, or remove the grounding wire from the oscilloscope power connector. And while testing, never touch these metallic connectors, because live voltage can appear in these connectors. Now I am setting probe to 1x to test current sense signal. I will connect at pin number 4 of this IC. So this is current sense signal. When I will remove charger, the signal is dropped. It is just only 400 millivolts peak. But when we connected load 1.1 ampere, we can see it is 700, 800 millivolt peaks. These voltage are dropped across this resistor when this IC is switching. This time it is switching at 37 kilohertz. Now I will set to 10x. And now I will connect at the drain pin, pin 5 and 6. These are the switching pulses. It is switching pulse and here is off period. Off time vs on time. If I will remove the charger, we can see this IC is now maintaining the power because there is no load, so it will switch one cycle and then it will wait. In no load condition, it will reduce its frequency. Now it is switching at 4 kHz, 4 kHz to 8 kHz, but when we will put the load at that time, it will maintain its frequency at 37 kHz. 37 kilohertz. So in this way we can verify the function of this IC. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.